down the veil, knowing all the lives it'll cost.
We shared a journey years ago. Do you believe that I would do this if there was some other better option?
The pillar's weak, but it isn't falling. We need to push it. Right! Together! Now!
You came a long way and made a valiant effort, Varric, but this story does not end with my downfall.
You have no idea what you have done.
Solas? I know what I did. I stopped you from destroying the world.
I was not destroying the world. When you disrupted my ritual, the magical energies pulled me here, into the Fade.
Okay, so that's why you're here. But why am I here?
Your physical body is unconscious, but you shed a few drops of blood at the ritual site. Enough for a tenuous connection.
Blood magic?
Firstly, I abhor the use of blood magic. Secondly, had I the power to control you, I would already have used it.
All right. You brought me here to talk. What are we talking about?
The Evanurus, or as you would call them, the Elven Gods. The creatures that escaped. In ancient times, they ruled the Elves, but that was not enough. They sought not just to be obeyed, but to be worshipped. When I rebelled, they drew on the horrific magic of the Blight, corrupting all they saw until I trapped them. Thanks to you, though, I am now trapped. And the blighted Elven Gods walk free.
Thanks to me, I wasn't the one performing a big ritual to free them.
Free them? My mortal enemies. I was ensuring that they would never escape their prison.
You were tearing down the veil.
I had a plan.
Varric always said you'd have a big explanation for why none of this was your fault.
Varric?
Yeah, he said that's your style. Never quite lies, clever half-truths that let you convince yourself you're doing the right thing. He tried to talk to you anyway, and now he's hurt.
Varric is quite practiced at shading the truth himself.
So those things that got out, you said they were gods?
They said they were gods. Blighted, tyrannical, sadistic gods. It took all my power to imprison them millennia ago. But I am certain you will be fine.
That's really helpful. What are you, the elven god of sarcasm?
Lies, treachery, and rebellion, depending upon the story. And how could I help? I do not have my ritual dagger. I cannot access my network of mirrors to travel from the lighthouse to anywhere in the world. All I can offer is what I know.
Helpful advice from the elven god of, and I am quoting you here, lies, treachery, and rebellion.
Depending on the story. Elganan and Gilanane are your problem to solve. This is your responsibility now.
Why? Why tear down the veil?
You need to listen.
No!
You have no idea what you have done. This is your responsibility now.
Well, look who's still with us.
Varric, you're okay, but I saw Solas stab you. You fell.
Trust me, kid. I've had worse. And it'd take more than a flesh wound to stop me. Don't think I'll be making it out to the field anytime soon, though.
What happened?
Remember how you said that Chuckles wasn't going to listen, Rook? Oh, turns out you were right.
The plan did go a little wrong.
Yeah. Harding got everyone out. By the skin of her teeth, mostly. Before you start worrying, Nev will be fine. She's apparently a lot tougher than both of us put together. Or, at least, she's a lot tougher than me.
I should have come up with a better plan. I should have...
You worked with what you had. And you succeeded, by the way. World isn't drowning in demons.
It isn't over, though. We trapped Solas in the Fade, but something else got out. Something...
Rook, you've got this. I've seen your work. Like that time you ditched your orders for a better strategy during a darkspawn attack. There's a reason I dragged you into this whole Solas mess. You're clever, adaptable, and you don't know when to quit.
Rook, look who's awake. I've been searching the place for Lyrian potions. Didn't mean to intrude.
Not at all. I was just about to have a look around.
Oh, be careful if you go outside, Rook. It is a long way down. The alluvion led us into something, and it's in the Fade. Because that's what we needed. The dream world.
Then I really need to look around.
Can't hurt. In theory. And we need to talk about our next move. Maybe find Harding? She went outside somewhere. There's a table in the central area here. I'll meet you both there.
Go ahead, Rook. Me. I need to sleep. See you later, kid.
Thank you.
I wish I could be out there with you, Rook. Just be careful, all right?
we're awake. And we're in the Fade. This is where people come when they dream, but dwarves don't dream. And somehow I'm here.
Yeah, it's unreal. Nev thought we should talk about what to do next.
We should, but maybe look around a little. We might be here a while.
Wisps. Figures are in the Fade, but I swear they're following me.
You all right?
Strange place you've fallen into, but I'll work with it. You know me.
Do I?
I know Varric wanted you for the job. You know the same about me.
I'm in a call that got you injured right after we met.
I'll be fine. You trusted me for the job, and I delivered. That's what counts. If we're stuck in this, let's hope you can trust me again.
Of course I do. We're a team.
Is this how fast you trust anyone? Should I be touched or worried?
You take a lot of notes. What about?
Lately, what we know, or knew, before Solas changed the game.
And it's?
Not much. I'm sure Lace would hate to hear that, but one step at a time.
Okay. So step one is figure out what we're chasing.
Right. And the 20 other questions that need answers?
That's step two.
I can see why Varric brought you on.
We've just got to start somewhere. It wasn't supposed to go this way.
What do we do now? What do we do? Harding?
Oh, hey, Rook. How's it going?
Did you ever find places like this, chasing Solas with Varric?
Not exactly. But with Solas, it was always about the Fade, or the Veil, or some other in-between place. Varric always hated it, though. At least this place feels different. Maybe safer?
So you have plants. Greenery's nice, isn't it?
Green? Most of these are dead. Figures. Maybe I'll clear them out. Give me something to do. I hate sitting around. We shouldn't be sitting around. We were going to go back through the Illuvian, right? Let's start with that. As soon as we can.
You know you can take some time to just...
Now you sound like Varric. Varric and I started this. And I can't stop. Not now. Don't ask me to. So, come get me when you're ready to go. All right?
Two more.
So, we stopped the ritual.
And Varric paid the price.
Hey, Varric made his choice to go talk with Solas. He knew the risks. We all did.
And now Solas is gone. And we're here. Wherever here is. Besides in the Fade.
Solas called it the Lighthouse.
He did? When?
Well, I was out cold. He showed up in my dream, and he's really mad that we stopped his ritual.
Good.
He's also trapped in some kind of prison in the Fade. Not happy about that either.
You're sure that wasn't just a dream? It's a reasonable reaction.
Solas can speak with people in their dreams, even kill them.
I'm safe on that front. I bled a little when I got knocked out. Enough that he can gripe at me, but not enough that he can make my head explode.
So Solas is using blood magic? Like any normal mage would to play with your mind.
But he's not a normal mage, like I told you. He's an elven god.
Putting together a nice ritual doesn't make him a god.
He nearly brought down the veil, Nev. Can you do that?
You know it's not that simple.
He may not be a prayers and blessings kind of god, but he's a lot more than just a mage.
All right. Well, we've stopped the ritual, and there doesn't seem to be an immediate danger. For now. You're certain Solas can't use blood magic to affect your mind?
I'm not certain of anything. But we're not out of danger.
What do you mean?
Solas had two of the other elven gods imprisoned. When he got trapped, they escaped.
So those things we saw come out of the Fade when the ritual went wild, those are...
Elgernon and Gilinane. Two of the ancient elven gods that Solas rebelled against. Solas warned me about them being evil, which is pretty rich from the guy who just tried to tear down the veil.
You don't believe him?
No, that's the problem. I do believe him. He said they were horrific tyrants.
Tyrants so powerful, elven history remembers them as gods.
Solas says Elgernon and Gilinane drew on the Blight for power and became corrupted. That was when he imprisoned them.
So instead of one god running around, we have two. And they're not just powerful, they're blighted.
We need to get out there and stop them.
Just like that. We're down a man without Varric. We can't just rush in.
I know you're hurt, Nev. But the rest of us need to do something.
I'll be ready to fight when it's time, but we need to investigate, then figure out what we're dealing with.
And how many more people will get hurt, get killed, while we spend time investigating?
If Elgernon and Gilinane are worse than Solas, we don't have time to waste. We need to act now.
We don't know what they can do or what they want. We don't even know if Solas is telling the truth.
I'm not saying we go in blind, but this time, if we see a shot, we take it.
All right. The last place we saw them was the ritual site.
The Illuvian took us here from the ritual site, instead of back to Minrathis.
Then let's hope it takes us back.
Nev, are you okay to go?
It's a headache. I've worked with worse.
All right, then. Let's get back to the ritual site.
The Illuvian has its own special room. It's just down the stairs.
For all we know, there's a dozen demons waiting on the other side of that Illuvian.
If it even takes us back to Arlathan.
Nev, you sure you're up for this?
Don't worry about me. Shall we?
Let's do this.
It's quiet. Well, isn't that a surprise?
There's the ritual site. But if the gods really did get out, they're not here anymore.
Right. Let's take a look around and see if we can find any...
Strife? Irlen? It's me, Lace Harding.
Harding? What are you doing back in Arlathan?
It's complicated.
I can see that.
Rook, Nev, this is Strife and Irlen. Varric and I met them when we first started hunting down Solas. They're veil jumpers, experts in ancient elven magic.
Hardly experts. I should have been able to shut that artifact down. I'm sorry, Tarith.
It's not your fault. Since the sky ripped open, the magic's been surging. Bunch of artifacts that had been dormant for centuries started coming alive. This is because of Finn Harrell's... Sorry, Solas's ritual, isn't it? You all were supposed to stop him.
Didn't see you volunteering. We put our lives on the line to stop Solas, and we stopped him.
Not without a cost.
Sky's not ripping itself apart anymore, is it?
All right. You stopped Solas. So why is Arlathan neck deep in wild magic?
Solas was dragged into the Fade when we interrupted his ritual, but something else got out.
Someone else, supposedly. Elgrinnon and Gilinane.
Mithalanest. Two of the elven gods of old. The Evanuris.
Shit. If they're back in the world, that explains a lot.
Ah, I was really hoping the Dreadwolf was lying to us about all this.
He's the god of lies. But some things are sacrosanct, even to him. He might be a bastard, but he's a damn sight better than the Evanuris.
There's a reason Solas led a rebellion against the Evanuris. And a reason he imprisoned them.
But now they've escaped.
Tarith is in bad shape. We need to get him back to the camp.
We've still got dozens of veil jumpers unaccounted for.
How can we help?
We need to find Belara Luter. She's the best there is at working with our ancient artifacts.
And also at blowing them up.
She was off looking for another artifact before this ritual shook everything loose. If anyone can get a handle on all this wild magic and the artifact it's setting off, it'll be her.
Right. You get your friend back to your camp and... we'll find Belara.
Nev, you're injured. Stay here with the veil jumpers.
It's a headache. I'll be fine.
I know you want to help, but we don't know what we'll face out there, and you're in no condition to fight.
All right. Just watch your backs.
We'll meet you back at the Veil Jumper Camp. It's just south of here.
Belara's out near some elven ruins to the west. At least she was 3 days ago. I'd start your search there.
Good luck, Rook. And thank you.
Thank you.
Is it me, or is there something strange about this fog?
It all feels a little off. Like everything shifted a little bit. Is that suit of armor moving? Gotcha! Oh! People! Where'd you come from?
Belara? Belara Luthere? Strife and Irulan sent us to find you.
Who are you, exactly?
Call me Rook.
Lace Harding. Protocol is to wait a full week before they send anyone out to look for me? I've only been gone 3 days.
Well, the situation's changed. For the worse, unfortunately. The elven gods Elgernon and Gilanane have escaped Fenharel's prison. And it seems like they want to destroy the world.
Oh! Yes, that is very much for the worse. Okay, wait. I need a second.
I've had a couple of days, and I'm still trying to wrap my head around it.
It does sort of explain a few things, though.
Like what?
The surge of raw magic in the area. These artifacts started waking up a while ago, but in fits and starts. One here, a couple there. Then, a couple of days ago, the sky split open. And now, raw magic. Thick as fog. Only a god or gods could have done that. There's something kind of exciting about it. And dangerous. Really dangerous. Dangerous enough that I was gonna head back to the Veiljumper camp, but...
But what?
See that shimmer? That's a veil bubble. It's separating us from the rest of the real world, so to speak. You can only pass through it one way. Once you're in, you can't get out.
We don't have time for this. Let's just force our way out.
Oh, I wouldn't do that. I don't know what contacting that much raw magic would do to you. But there's another way. A bubble like that? There has to be something at the center that's generating it. Something powerful. If we can find it and remove it, safely, I mean, the bubble itself should collapse.
And then we're back in reality?
I really, really hope so.
Well then, let's get going.
I've been trying to get to the artifact at the center of the bubble, but these magical constructs keep getting in the way.
We've handled our share of demons. A few dozen more shouldn't be a problem.
Spirits, not demons. They're animating those suits of armor. The armor's attuned to the artifact to protect it from threats.
Threats like us, I'm guessing.
Is that water just swirling into the air?
We call that kind the whirlpool. The anomaly, I mean. Never seen one this size, though.